Like song.
Hello. My name is Nadia Rus. I'm artist. I created new style in visual arts, neo-pop realism. Neo-pop realism combines brightness and simplicity of pop art with deep and philosophical realism. And when you get famous as me, there's lots of kind of stuff you can hear about self. Like rumors, like biographies written, some people you know who is authors. So I went by accident on the internet and I found some interesting biography about myself. And I feel obligated to give some comments. But before I give comments, I am reading this biography. Neo-pop realism. A famous post-mortem biography of the pop band Neo-pop and its founder, Nadia Crazy Legs Russ, written by her radical artist, singer, friend, and relative, Russ Abbott. A summary. Neo-pop realism picks up shortly after Nadia Rose's conviction for attempting to poison her lover, the increasingly alien land baron Ziggy Stardust, for the purpose of collecting on his multi-million dollar life insurance policy. The next five chapters describe with exquisite details her ordeals as she, it's me, served a 12-year sentence in a penal colony located somewhere in the harsh, frozen wilds of Alaska, where her days and nights were spent unwillingly participating in games after games of no rules, topless beer fighting. As the book goes on the recount, Nadia left the prison a grim and hardened woman, tempered, steely cold from her baptism by fire. She briefly attempted to lead a straight life, but was soon consumed by her own unbridled spite for Ziggy Stardust, who was by then a retrofitted suborg and lead singer of the popular band Jet Jackson and His Flying Something. As you understood, my English is not good enough to understand what I am reading, but I hope you understand me. Determined to knock him clean off the charts, she decided to form her own band, and band based on the violent philosophy she had adopted during her mine incarceration. It was her final dream. She would call it Neo Pop. Unfortunately for Nadia, the public's reception of Neo Pop was mediocre at best. It was instantly panned by reviewers, in particular for Steve Ballmer's amateur keyboarding skills and repetitions, tracks such as Let's Go to the Beach, Sally Sally. The band soon began to fall apart amidst vicious infighting, which would finally culminate in the stabbing death of drummer Oscar Wilde. Wearing broken, Nadia subsequently lost much of her sanity and began wandering the streets as a disheveled vagrant, frantically ifling through garbage cans in her mad search for twine, which she by this time believed would open her door to Nirvana. It was in her sad state that Nadia Rus would meet her ultimate and tragic demise as a civilian casualty during the War of Superbikes. Also, a funeral and several memorial services were held in her mine honor. It was on this note that the author, Russ Abbott, choose to end near path realism. Russ Abbott on the subject of Nadia, my subject. It's kind of funny, you know, I only met Nadia once. People think I knew her, but everything in the book I really just got from plain old research. I remember I was so strung out of the time I offered to bank her for 2 lobster tails. She rejected. Then I offered to let her bank me. She said, I want a diamond necklace and Lamborghini. You know what happened next? Russ Abbott shortly wrote before his death. Dedications. Russ Abbott dedicated neo-pop realism to his dog Champ. Champ made his billions and dedicated neo-pop realism to some puppy from Central America. Now I feel obligated to give some comments. First of all, I never was in jail. Second, I never was in Alaska, even as a tourist. Third, I never was playing in band neo-pop. I never saw even Russ Abbott. And I don't know what does it mean word even bank. Bank? So I can't figure out what he meant when he was talking about necklace and lobster tails. And dedications, it's total absurd. That's it.